Hello, this is Adam Zuercher with Hixon Zuercher Capital Management, and today I'm going to share our first economic update of 2019. In today's video, I'm going to go over the events that happened in the market and the economy in December and share with you how we ended up the year. So how did we close out 2018? Well, in short, it was a very challenging month. As you can see, we had more down days than we did up days, as you can see by all the red on the chart. Going back to the very beginning of the month, through the close of trading on Christmas Eve, the Dow Jones Industrial Average dropped nearly 4,000 points. In fact, Christmas Eve was the worst Christmas Eve that we've had on record, with the Dow dropping about 3% in just half a day's worth of trading. However, the day after Christmas was a big turnaround, as the Dow posted its largest point gain ever, with more than 1,000 point gain. In this chart, you can see how the major market averages performed for the full year 2018. So here we have the Dow Jones in white, we have the S&P 500 in green, and the NASDAQ composite in pink. As you can see, in September, the markets were trading near all-time highs, only to finish the year with the second correction of the year. In fact, December was the worst December on record for both the Dow and the S&P 500, as both indexes were down about 10%. And all three indexes had their worst calendar year in over a decade. The Dow was down 5.6%, the S&P 500 down 6.2%, and the NASDAQ down 3.9% counting dividends. So why did we have such a big reversal at the end of the year? Well, investors seem to be hypersensitive to headlines during the fourth quarter of 2018. Investors were worried that economic growth was beginning to come in below expectations. They were worried about the Federal Reserve and their interest rate policies. Also, bringing concern was the ongoing trade tension, especially with China. And as the market started to have some negative days, there was much computer-generated trading going on, just making matters worse. And then by the end of the year, investors began to be concerned about the government shutdown, which was on its 10th day on New Year's Eve. So in spite of all these headlines, the Federal Reserve actually increased rates during December for the fourth time in 2018. Going all the way back to 2015, the Federal Reserve has increased rates now 9 times in this economic expansion. Chairman Powell indicated that the reason that the Fed increased rates in December, even though the market seemed not to want rates to go up, was because the economy continues to grow, even in spite of the concerns that investors have, the trade tensions, and the government shutdown. The economy is growing. This chart shows you longer-term perspective of the Fed funds policy. So you can see now that we're at 2.5%, that is still much below where we were with interest rates before the recession of 2008-2009. So it's our opinion that the Fed did the right thing by increasing interest rates, even when the market was saying they shouldn't. The Fed needs to continue to increase rates so that we get back to a more normalized level, so that there's room to cut interest rates in the next economic downturn. This chart shows you GDP growth, and in the most recent quarterly reading, the economy grew 3.4%, which is well above the expansion average of just 2.3% since the last recession, and is also above the long-term average of 2.7%. So in spite of all the headlines, all the worries, and the market volatility that we've had in December, the economy continues to grow. And it's our opinion that what we experienced during the fourth quarter is just a normal correction, and we're still in a longer-term bull market. Well, you might be wondering how all of this impacts you. We will continue to watch the market, the economy, and if things change economically, we will adjust our clients' portfolios. If you have any questions about your portfolio, feel free to give us a call. We'd love to sit down with you and chat about your situation. You can reach us by calling 419-425-2400, or you can go to our website at hzcapital.com. Well, that's it for this month. Again, I'm Adam Zuercher with Hixon Zuercher Capital Management.